100%. And so my final question to you, super quick, is that what are the different kind of industries that young India should look at and say, haan, wahan growth hone wali hai. That's why I'll grow my own career.
There are two ways of looking at it. There are many industries, and for me, the number one industry is travel. It's the reason kya hai ki traditionally, if you look at it, and the Marwadi communities, the Gujarati communities know this very well. Roti, kapda, makan. People will eat, isn't it? Mm. So food industry will always be there with a lot of innovation. Kapda, we like fashion, fiber, makan, you know, we always like housing infrastructure. But we have forgotten that one of the key industries for India is travel. They love to travel, isn't it? We just came back from Nagpur. Mm. Tomorrow we're going to go there. Airline industry, hotel industry, everything is interconnected. We actually don't give importance to travel in this particular country. Travel is not a career. Mm. It is something that you do logistically. But do you know how big it is? And it's unfortunate that Jet Airways failed in such an industry. Mm. Somewhere the management system didn't know, but it's not good for an economy. So when I say travel, when I speak to a lot of people, what are the career options, engineers, doctors, and how slowly that's dying off. The whole idea is that they never looked at travel, which is India's biggest thing. There are countries which are dependent on travel. If you look at Singapore or many other countries, how can we not look at it? So coming back to the young generation should give importance to travel. Second industry probably it's very important to know anything and everything connected to heritage. See, Indian heritage is coming back in its big way. For example, again, thanks to Modi ji, he's promoting a lot of cultural tourism. Mm. But cultural tourism is not about the travel. I already told you about travel. So when you go to a particular place, can you hold them? Mm. Maybe doing a research. So let me give an example. If you go to Ujjain temple. Ujjain temple? One Shiva great temple? No. But there is a system of knowledge in Ujjain temple that if you go there, they'll actually tell you whether your grandfather came to this temple.
Wow.
If you actually go to places like Tirupati or you go to Kerala, so there are knowledge system we don't know. So what I'm saying is young people can get into research. And very important, if you look at current budget, you know, Nirmala Sitharaman, our first female full-time finance minister, actually has announced huge, huge, huge funds for R&D, research and development. So what I'm saying is that when are we looking at research? So for example, if you want to do research on social media, actually you can get 100 crores from the government of India or any particular field, IIT, IIM. So what I'm saying is that this youth is full of opportunities, but we are not thinking like a researcher. We're not looking at the future. We are looking at, you know, what is innovation. But 5 years after that, 5 years, Apple puts a lot of money in research. Okay, luckily there are Indian companies, for example, Patanjali. Mm. Like Baba Ramdev, do you know 500 crores is their annual budget for research, for R&D? And that's why they just go and, you know, almost touch Unilever in 5 years. Mm. But we don't see Patanjali, Baba Ramdev, yoga product, jeans, theek hai. So what I'm saying is that whatever be your field, I think the youth should focus on various industries. But whichever industry you are, probably the automobile industry, you know, the research is the future.
Got it. Anyway, okay, so that's the key decision. India went down because they stopped doing research.
Yes, I particularly feel that. Yeah.
Going up because they will do research.